There's a lot going on. And I can't tell you every single thing that happens.
Oh, why does somebody else have to die first? Look, if you're withholding evidence that has anything to do with the bombing at the Blues office, I want to know about it right now.
I need you to trust me on this and not ask me about
it. No, wait, excuse me. Was it your wife that died in that bombing?
Oh, for the love of God. And for your own sake, you need to separate how you feel from what you need.
All right, don't you condescend to me. All right, I'm going to tell you something. That unless you come clean with me about whatever evidence you have and what is going on here, I'm going to go to the commissioner.
And say what?
I'm going to say that you're withholding official evidence for starters. And I will do it.
All right, I'll tell you.
Now why you were so hot to get out of here before.
What?
You're meeting Eden here. You're having a little meeting for the Concerned Friends of Kelly Society, maybe? Didn't want me to catch you again?
Look, I didn't even know Eden was going to be anywhere around here tonight.
Like I said, Craig, you used to be a much better liar.
I'm not sure. But I bet I know where she's heading.
Where?
She's gonna watch a little TV.
I have evidence connecting CC to the bombing.
CC?
He didn't do it. I'm certain it was planted by Harlan Richards to discredit the Campwells. Whether for business or personal reasons, I have no idea.
What makes you so sure?
This has to stay between us.
Okay.
Harlan Richards has a criminal file on my mother. It regards something that happened a long time ago, and the implications are enormous. She was not responsible for what happened, but I have no way of proving that. He is holding this file over my head to try to keep me from investigating the bombing.
And you're letting him blackmail you even though Nikki died in that bombing?
I am doing the best I can under a difficult set of circumstances. I understand how you feel. Mm-hmm. Michael, I understand how
you feel.
Oh, do you? Yes, I do. You cannot expect me to throw caution to the wind. Okay. I'm going to nail the man. I am close. I'm this close to getting the evidence.
How close is that?
I have a good lead.
Oh.
I do. I'm going to go down to South America today and follow it up. I need time. You got to give it to me. I want to nail that bastard every bit as bad as you do. But I cannot let my mother go to prison.
All right, you have no right to ask this of me. Listen to me, listen to me. Whoever killed Nikki is going to pay, and I'm going to see to that personally. Now, if you want a little time, that's all you're going to get.
Yes.
same man, and the transformation almost certainly took place in Brazil. Maybe this is the break we've been waiting for, but I want you out of this country while I'm gone. I want you safe in Mexico, in case Richards gets wind of what I'm doing and decides to release the report he's holding.
But would he really do that? It's the only thing he has to hold over you.
You agreed to do this, and I expect you to keep your promise.
I know, but I don't want to.
If I have to put you on that plane myself, I will. Over my shoulder.
All right, already. You're so determined.
Yes, I am.
I'm going to pack.
Thank you.
It'll only take a minute.
Good.
So what time are you leaving?
4 o'clock.
Well, that doesn't give us much time. How long are you going to be gone?
I don't know. Hopefully not more than a couple of days. I just hope I can come up with some kind of evidence to prove that Richards and Atkins were the same man. Then that damn file won't mean anything.
You know, I got to thinking, what if Harlan finds out that you're in Brazil looking for evidence on him? What if he sends a guy after you?
I'll be careful. I'm always careful.
No, you're not. You take chances. I wish you wouldn't take this one.
Well, baby, I have to do this. You think I can't? You know why I have to go do this, right?
Yes. But I don't have to like it.
Well, I don't have to like it either. I just have to do it. Oh, come on. 2 or 3 days. It'll fly by. Mm. I'll be back before you know it.
Impossible.
About the bird?
Yeah.
What is the joke about the bird?
Put it on my bill.
Put it on my bill? Did your mommy tell you that joke about a duck and its bill?
Yes.
Okay, well, did you laugh?
Yeah.
Good, that's important. When she tells you those jokes, you've got to laugh. Now, I want you to know that I'm going to be going away for a little while.
Okay.
Okay? You're going to have to be the man of the family. You're going to have to take care of your mom and your little sister. Can you do that?
Uh-huh.
What are you talking about? Oh, John is still asleep. She's waking up.
Well, that's all right.
Hey, big guy.
Go upstairs and whisper in her ear. You all said, Mama?
I'm not taking much because I don't expect to be gone long.
Well, I don't expect you'll be gone long either. Just give me a second. I'm going to go up and say goodbye to my baby, and then we'll be leaving. Come
here, Jim. Oh, Jim. Can Grandma have another hug? Please. No.
I'll be back in a second.
Well, tell Rick we love him.
I will. I'm just sorry Cruz so set on my going. I don't like running away from things.
Yeah, I know, but I do think it's the safest thing for you, and he'll be able to do his job without worrying about you.
I realize that, but I just...
Oh, I just pray he can get to the bottom of this terrible nightmare once and for all, and we can all be together again. Just the way we should always be.
Okay,
together, okay? Always.
You call us. You tell us when you get there. I'll say.
Oh, okay. Take care. And please, I want to know about Cruz. As soon as you hear something, you call me.
Absolutely. I sure will.
Okay, so you set the roll here?
Yes.
Okay. Goodbye. Bye-bye. Have a safe trip.
Okay. I'll wait in the car.
Okay, thank you, Mama.
Sweetheart.
So you be a good girl. Try not to get messed up in this Robert Kelly stuff. That's bad for your spirits.
Mm-hmm, I understand. You be a good boy.
Yeah.
Come back to me in one big boy piece.
I will, I promise. I've got too much at stake here not to show up in a hurry.
Okay. I love you.
I love you too. And I love the way you love me.
Cruz! You taking off?
Yeah. Hopefully I won't be gone more than a couple days.
It's about as long as I'm going to stay away from Richard's.
Now, brother, you're going to have to promise me that you'll be more patient than that. We'll get Richards. We'll put him away. But you go making a move right now, and you can blow it. You got to promise me you'll wait until I get back. You got to promise me that. For what he tried to do to Rick and my mama, and for what he did to Nikki, the man will pay. I swear to you. You going to wish me luck? For Eden for me?
You count on that.
You got here so quickly.
Well, I was anxious to see why somebody who'd walk right past me without saying anything would want to see me.
We have some interesting company here. The two of you know each other, of course.
Do you know what this is about?
It's really very simple. I have some wonderful news. And when I asked myself who I wanted to share it with, I immediately thought of the two of you. After all, I could think of no one else who is so concerned with every move I make. At least every move that involves Robert. And this involves Robert. We've set a date for the wedding. It's 4 weeks away. So I suggest the two of you reschedule any conflicts because I would not want to walk down that aisle without the two of you right there by my side, wishing me all the best.